Hey everyone, thanks for joining me in here today. Hope you and your plants are doing great. Today I'm going to prune one of my oldest plant, my Ficus benjamina, or commonly called weeping fig. I've been putting this off for a very long time, but today is the day. Hope you enjoy this video. This plant has been with me more or less in the same spot for more than 4 years now. If you own a ficus, you might know that this plant doesn't like changes or to be moved, even if it is for good. Since I moved this plant a lot during its initial days, it lost almost 90% of its leaves, and it took almost 2 years to get back to at least this situation. That's the thing about nature, right? They come back from nothing. Now the growth of this plant is not uniform on all sides. On one side it is leggy, but on the other side it is more or less bald. Generally, people prune ficus to maintain its shape. The plant can grow pretty wild and outgrow its pot. Even though the growth of my ficus is not uniform, it is taking up a lot of space in my living room. It is also better to prune them in its dormant period, that is late fall and winter. Now that the spring season is just around the corner, I'm going to give it some shape. I've completely no idea how it'll turn out. Before pruning, I'm giving it a good shake to remove all the weak and dead leaves. They shed a lot of leaves in winter, which is quite normal. There is nothing to worry about. I want to give this plant a whole new look, so I'm removing all the existing ties and clips already on the plant. Before pruning, it is a good idea to disinfect all the pruning tools so that no diseases or pests are transmitted from other plants. To prune the plant, we need to find a node. A node is simply where the leaf meets the stem. I'm giving it a cut just an inch above a node. This will encourage the plant to put out new growth sideways, making it bushier rather than being leggy. For the ficus plant, once a cut is made, a sap is produced. This shows that the node is healthy and has the capability to grow back. But this sap could also be an irritant to the skin. This is the reason why I'm wearing a glove. So, safety first. Quite opposite to a healthy node, the dead branches do not produce any sap. I'm cutting off all the dead stems and branches, as they'll anyway not grow back. I'm also cutting off the lower branches. This is also beneficial to the plant, as the lower leaves often attracts pests and disease. Tying back the branches to get to the shape which I have in mind. I'm pruning the foliage a bit and also the stems and branches that are leggy and taking up a lot of space around. My ficus got badly attacked by thrips this winter, so I'm going to give it a nice shower to remove all the pest and dust from the leaves. After drying for some time, I'm spraying some neem oil solution. This can prevent the pests from coming back. So, are you ready for the final look? Here is the before shot. And there you go. This is the after shot. This was pretty much the shape I wanted. A long trunk and foliage only on the top. Now it doesn't look perfect, but when it grows back in summer, hopefully it'll look more bushier. This is the amount of leaves that I cut off from the ficus, or the mess that I created. I'm going to try to propagate a few branches so that I can have a whole new ficus benjamina tree someday. After removing the lower leaves, I'm going to put them in water, place them in a bright spot and wait for it to root. As always, updates will be on my Instagram. Also, if you want to read more about pruning ficus, head on to my blog. You can find the link in the description box below. And don't forget to let me know how you like the new look of my ficus benjamina in the comment box below. See you in another video. Bye and take care.